Hey, my name is Phil from legitmarketingreviews.com. In today's video, we're going to be looking at a video hosting platform called Publitio. Now, in this Publitio review, I want to share with you exactly what this tool does, how it actually works, and by the end of this video, you should know if it's right for you. And if you're thinking about getting started with Publitio, there is actually a lifetime deal going on right now. It's very exclusive, not many people know about it, and I'll link to that in the description, so make sure you go ahead and check that out. Okay, so first of all, what is Publitio? Well, it is a video and file hosting platform, which basically means you can upload your different files to their servers, which uses a CDN, so it's fast around the world no matter where you are. And then on top of that, you get to put in what's called an HLS encryption, which means it's hard for hackers and plagiarism people to steal your content, right? So this is perfect for content creators. This is perfect for people who create courses, things like that. And to be honest, it's probably my favorite Vimeo alternative because of that, but also because it's much cheaper. So what I'm going to do right now is actually jump behind the screen and show you Publitio. Okay, so first of all, we're going to start here at the Publitio website. What I want to do first is run through some of the different features that they have, which are listed on their website. I'm also going to go through the different pricing. I'll then show you the secret lifetime deal that they currently have going on, and then I'll go behind the screen and show you how it all works. So first of all, if we come to solutions, you will see here there is all of the different things that it does. For example, you can host your media assets, your digital assets, your video management, image management, audio management, and you can also offload some of your WordPress files, which basically means they're going to host it on their CDN rather than you hosting it on your WordPress hosting, which is going to make it much faster. Now, some of the other features you get, which is HLS streaming, which is like I mentioned earlier, they have that layer of HLS encryption on top of the videos, and I'll show you what that means a bit later on, which means it's harder for people to download. You also have different types of video processing, image and video watermarking, image and video CDN. So it means not only videos, but you can also host images on their CDN, making it faster to load on your website. Then you get analytics. You can also see the GPO video conversion and videos on demand. So there's loads of different things inside of here. Most people will be just using it for HLS streaming and maybe hosting different types of files on their CDN. So now I'm going to quickly go over the different pricing, just so you know what you're in for if the lifetime deal is finished. So we have here what's called the Lifetime Hacker, and it's free to start. It's always free to use, so you can go ahead and get started with this today, and it's going to allow you to start using it. And with that, for $0 per month, you get to have up to 100 gigabytes of storage, which means you can use up to 500 gigabytes of monthly bandwidth, right? And then you also get to use one CNAME, and most importantly, you get to have HLS video encryption included. So that's pretty cool. Now, the domain level protection goes with the HLS. Basically, if I was using my website, right, legitmarketingreviews.com, if I put in my domain here, legitmarketingreviews.com, then it will play on that domain. But any other domain that tries to steal it, right? So if they got the link to the video and put it on their website, it won't play. So it's really, really powerful. Then finally, if you start running out of storage, if you start getting more people coming, then you're just going to have to upgrade to $9 per month, right? It's a flat fee. You don't have to pay yearly, anything like that. And it's just going to give you more storage. It's going to give you another CNAME. It's going to give you some more watermarks, players, things like that. And then you can use pay-as-you-go usage afterwards. Now, to be honest, I've never hit that much before. I've probably only still in the free plan, so there's plenty of usage. I actually got a lifetime deal plan a long time ago, and I absolutely love it. And speaking of lifetime deals, currently they have this Valentine's Day special going on. Now, they sometimes forget to pull down their page, so it's still live if you want to go ahead and check it out. But for $99, you can get the premium plan at a one-time price, just $99, and that's yours for life, which makes it a ridiculously good deal compared to things like Vimeo and Wistia, because you can get all of this and, most importantly, the HLS protection for your content. So what I'm going to do right now is go into my dashboard and show you how it works. So come to my dashboard here, and this is what I've been using. So as you can see, the bandwidth, I haven't used much. I'm on a higher tier plan, 500 gigs a month, and I've barely used 5. And also type the total storage is less than 27 gigabytes out of my 100 gigabyte quota. So I've got plenty to go inside of it. Now on the left, it's a pretty straightforward looking dashboard. It's not as pretty as Vimeo or Wistia. It's more sort of targeted to people who want to see analytics, people who want to get functionality versus, you know, customer experience, which a lot of people are quite interested in. But on the left, we've got here dashboards, notifications, which you won't really need to worry about. And then we've got here manage. So we have files, versions, players, ads, and watermarks. Then we've got analytics, API referrals, billing, and settings, right? So it's all very straightforward. At the top, we've also got just the website links from like before. But what I'm going to do is actually show you how this works. So I'm going to come across, I'm just going to pause the video and come to a folder so you don't see too many important docs. Okay, so here's a video I uploaded this morning. This is a bridge video for a free funnel that I've been giving away. But let me just show you the entire process of how everything works. So first of all, we've got here copy. This is if you want to share it. We've got here rename, open URL, copy URL, share, and also download button. But what I'm going to do to start with is click on upload files. I'm going to choose the demo free bridge video. And then when you come inside here, it's going to ask, you know, what type of settings do you want to add to it? So set files privacy to public. Now, this makes it so other people can actually see it. If you just had it on private, no one would be able to see it at all. But what we want to do is enable HLS video encryption. Click on more, and here you'll see allow URL transformations, which is completely fine. But we have here allow download via player. We don't want that to be added. And what this means is if you unselect it, then no one can download it. Now, usually me personally, I also like to check another couple of things. So this one here, use file name for public ID generation. If you leave this checked, it's going to have the file name as what your file is. So like it's going to have demo-free-funnel-bridge. So we don't want that. We want them to use a randomly generated number or something like that, so it's harder for people to actually see. Then you can upload your own watermarks in the watermarks tabs. You can add in tags if you wish, and you can have different presets for the player too. I usually just leave everything quite standard. So I'll go ahead and start the upload and show you how this looks. I'll just pause the video and let it actually finish uploading. Look at that. Look how fast that is. It's crazy. Okay, so I just like stopped and started the recorder and it's already finished. But here it is. It's the same as before, except it has been freshly uploaded. Now, if you want to view it, you can click on view. If you want to edit it, you can edit it too. But what you want to do if you are like a course creator, if you want to embed your video on websites, let me show you how it works. So all you need to do is come to embed player codes. Click on this, and then what we want to embed with is the iframe. So click on copy iframe, and I've gone ahead and created a demo page, this one here, and I'll show you how you add it. It's the same on any page builder, right? So come across to your elements, find HTML, right, and then drag in the HTML box and add in the code like so. And that's it. That's pretty much done. So I'm going to just save the draft and preview it and show you how hard it is to actually download, right? So here's the video, it's all ready to go. I'll just mute my screen, but if I press play, see it's super fast to load, right? It's crazy quick and everything looks amazing. But the most important thing is there's no right click on this player at all. There's no download button, there's nothing like that. And if we want to get technical, right, so if I go to inspect, this is probably above a lot of people's heads, but if I click on the video itself, what we have here is just two files. We've got the thumbnail for the video, which is the first one it starts with, which you can change in the back end, of course. But we have here the blob. And as you can see, this is the file name here, right? This is the one that they've renamed it to. And it's pretty much impossible to download, right? If you take this URL and paste it into a new tab and you actually try to get anything out of it, there's no chance that you can. It's just a whole bunch of random stuff, right? So if I click on that, it's just going to take me to, you know, this file is not found, you're not allowed to see it, things like that. So I've tried and tried and tried to break into it, but I haven't been able to. So it's extremely powerful. Now, a lot of you may be wondering, hey, look, I've just been following your instructions, but I can't see the video. It says my domain has not been allowed to watch this video. I'll show you how that actually works. So inside of your dashboard, what you want to do is come down to settings. And then at the top here, we have domain protection. So you want to click on domain protection. And then all you do inside of here is add in all of your different domains that you want your videos to be played on. Now you might not be able to see it because I've blanked it out, but this is where you just add in your domains and then press save changes, and that's it. That's as simple as it is. And honestly, this thing is going to save your courses from being bootlegged and sold on these dodgy websites. And this is how you do it. So now you know how to add in things like that. What I'm going to do is also show you some different players you can create, right? So I'm going to come to players on the left, click on create player. And this is if you want to add in your own branding, your own colors, things like that. So ID, you can just make up one. I'm just going to call this the YouTube test. Okay, skin, you could choose a few different colors. So we've got gray, orange, blue, pink, green, inverted. So I might just choose inverted to make a bit of randomness. Now you can have autoplay if you want, and every time you use this player, it's going to automatically to work. You can also have mouse over if you want, so it's going to start once you mouse over it. You can choose if you want the control bars to be on, the thumbnails to be on the seek, so if you scroll across the video, it shows you what's going to be shown. You can choose your default quality. You can choose if you want it to be muted or not, the playback speed if you want that to be an option. You can also choose different buttons if you want to loop the video. So if it's like a promo 10 second video, you might want it to loop. And then you can also create an ID tag, or if you want to choose a specific size, responsive is usually the best one. So you go ahead, click on create, and then you've gone ahead and created your own player. So it's super cool, super easy. So now this is the video player that you see. See, it's got the inverted, so instead of being black, it's gray. And the play button itself isn't gray, it is a hollowy type color. So these are the settings, super easy to use, and then every time you upload a file, you just choose the player you want to use. So another feature that they do have in Publitio is ads, right? And for ads, this is pretty interesting. You can go ahead and create a tag. So let's just say this was for one of my websites. Let's just say Alamar. And tag URL, this is if you are with different advertising companies, you can add in either a VAST or a Google IMA ad tag. And what it means is every time someone goes to play your video, it's going to play a hosted ad, which is going to give you revenue, right? So this is more sort of aimed at blogging websites, right? You've probably seen a few news websites where you go to watch a video, they make you watch something for 10 seconds first. Same sort of scenario, you get to control, you know, who you want to advertise on your videos, things like that. It's pretty cool. Then finally, I'm going to just tell you about watermarks. So watermarks is pretty cool as well. You can go ahead and create your own watermark. Basically, you upload a file, just make sure it's the right size. If you do upload something and it's too big, too small, just adjust it. It's super easy. I'm not sure exactly where the perfect size for them are, but I assume it's something like 50 by 50. And then you can choose what you want to call it, choose where you want it positioned, and how far you want it off the side. So that's basically it. So that is Publitio, guys. There's also a community and a help FAQ if you want it there. But that's it. What I'm going to do right now is jump behind the screen. Just want to talk about a few extra things. Okay, so that was my Publitio review. As you can see, this is a fully featured website. The user experience might not be incredible. However, the HLS encryption makes your files extremely secure, so no one can go and steal them. Once again, this is perfect for course creators, perfect for people hosting their own websites, especially if you want to host your own ads on top. So I absolutely love Publitio. I've been using it for years. I'm going to use it for years in the future as well. And this is also my best Vimeo alternative. Once again, if you want to check out the current lifetime deal they have, I've linked to that below in the description. And if there's any other promotions going on, I'll try to update that link so you get the best possible price. Anyway, that's it for this video. If you enjoyed it and got some value, make sure you smash the thumbs up button. And if you haven't yet, hit subscribe. Loads of great deals, discounts, and reviews coming in the near future. See you on the next video.